Hello friends, welcome to GYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, currently we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics, and we daily cover two subtopics. And in this manner, we cover all the 12 subtopics in 6 days. And this process goes on and on in cyclic manner. And we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam, that is on 31st May. So on 2nd June is your prelims, and we will end this series only on 31st May. So let's start our discussion. So today is lecture of economy, lecture number 5. The first question is, consider the following about national agriculture market. First, it is a pan-India electronic trading portal. Second, it has replaced the Agricultural Produce Marketing Committee in all the states of India. Third, NAM price discovery mechanism will replace the minimum support mechanism from the next financial year. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct. That is first, that it is a pan-India electronic trading portal. And second is not correct. It has not been replaced by Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee in all states. Agriculture Produce Marketing Committees are there with the states. And agriculture in fact is a state subject, so it depends upon the states to remove these APMCs. So, and third is also incorrect. So for only one is correct, the answer is A. So the solution is A. Let's move on to the next question. So friends, we now have stopped giving explanation to every question. In case you wish to get the explanations PDFs, you can email us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or for that matter, you can contact us at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So this is our official number that is linked with Team Achieve IAS. So obviously there will be minimum cost of PDF subscription, but it is kept, it is deliberate kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability, and also it is kept for the purpose of our motivation, so that we people can help you, so that we also can sustain ourselves. Let's move on to the second question. Second question is, a council for trade development and promotion was constituted a few years back. Here we have been asked that what was the purpose of it. First, administration of export promotion scheme. Second, cooperation between center and the state for export promotion. So we have to choose that which of the above is correct. Let me tell you friends that this council for trade development and promotion was constituted to ensure the cooperation between the center and state for the export promotion. So it is not an executive body, that is, it is not concerned with administration of export promotion scheme. So the answer would be B, that is second only. So the solution is B. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is quite easy. Global corruption report is published by A, Transparency International, B, Association for Democratic Reforms, C, Human Rights Campaign, D, World Vision, and Oxfam International jointly. Let me tell you friends that the answer is Transparency International. So Transparency International releases your global corruption report. So the answer would be A, that is Transparency International. Let's move on to the next question. The quality of government's spending increases in which of these cases? First, increasing consumer subsidies. Second, more gross capital formation. Third, higher revenue expenditure. So we have to choose the correct answer from the codes given below. Let me tell you friends that the answer here would be second, that is more gross capital formation, because it would lead to the enhanced capital formation and enhanced production and enhanced growth. So the answer would be C, that is second only. So the solution is C. As I have told you, explanation PDFs are, you have to subscribe for that. And those explanation PDFs, if you want the explanation PDFs. Let's move on to the next question. Which of the following were the pillars of Nehru Mahalanobis strategy of development? First, high consumption rate to support consumer goods industries. Second, policies that promote competition of domestic firms with foreign firms. Third, import substitution. Fourth, capitalistic pattern of society. So we have to tell that which of the above is correct. Let me tell you friends that Nehru Mahalanobis strategy was basically focused on import substitution, and it was also focused on the development of heavy industry. So the answer would be 3, that is B only. Here it would be B, that is third only. So the solution is B. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following about TRIPS Plus. It is first, it is an outcome of Nairobi package at the WTO. Second, it is concerned with enhanced IPR protections in party nations. Third, India has ratified TRIPS Plus agreement. Let me tell you, friends, that here only one statement is correct, and that is second, that it is concerned with enhanced IPR protection in party nations. So the answer would be B. Let's move on to the next question. That is the last question of the day. In a socialist economy, first, market forces of supply and demand do not exist. Second, only those goods are produced which yield sustained profits. Third, the government guides the overall economic activity in the economy. So we have to choose the correct answer. Friends, let me tell you that basically in a socialist economy, everything is controlled by the government. So the answer would be third. That third statement is correct only. So the three only would be the answer, that is C. So the solution is C. Sorry friends, there is one more question. I thought this was the last. Let's move on to the next question. Subsidies do not allow prices to indicate the supply of a good and prevent the market from mixing the price of a subsidized goods. Reason: all the goods and services subsidized by the government come under administered price regime. So we have to choose the correct. Let me tell you friends, both A and R are incorrect. So the answer would be here, that is D, that both A and R are incorrect. So the solution is D. So this is all about friends today's lecture. In case you want the explanations of these PDFs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So in case you want the PDFs, you can contact us at this number. This is all about today's lecture. If you liked it, then do hit a like, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important updates that we do on our channel. So thank you friends, have a very nice day.